Sir.
Yeah, good morning all. So in the previous classes we have seen about this different types of constructors, okay, constructor with the default arguments, okay, in which we have this constructor with the default arguments, in which we will define this constructor with the default arguments, like always the constructor should be same, having the same name as that of the name of the class, and it is taking some parameters. If it is taking parameters, that is called parameterized constructor, and if those values are given on this part, if you are initializing those values, then those are called default arguments. So this we have seen, and later we discussed about copy constructor, which is nothing but if the same class object will be sending as a parameter to the class, then I can say that can be by value or by reference. Okay, it may not be a issue. Like if only the name of the same class object will be sending as a parameter to the constructor, then that is called copy constructor, and that can be sent by the value or reference. So that is your copy constructor we have seen, and multiple constructors we are defining inside the constructor, that is called inside a class, that is called constructor overloading. So we have seen about all these topics in the previous class. So in the 2 days class we will discuss one of the last topic for the constructor concept, that is dynamic constructor, and after completion of this one we will see what is operator overloading, that is another part of this one. Okay, so we have one more type of constructor called dynamic constructors. So what is this dynamic constructor is, when the allocation of this memory is done dynamically using dynamic memory allocation or dynamic memory allocator new. So in a constructor, within the constructor, for the what is the purpose of constructor? So constructor is a special member function which is used to initialize the data members of the class. So class lo unnatundi data members ni nen initialize cheyadaniki I am using this constructor at the time of object creation itself. But whatever the initialization of those data, that I am doing dynamically, means the allocation of those data members, memory will be allocated dynamically by using this new operator, then those type of constructors are called dynamic constructor. Got it? All of you got it right? Constructor lopala nenu general ga initialize chestanu. So what is the purpose of this constructor? We will see. It is known as dynamic constructor. So if the allocation of the memory to the data members of a class is done dynamically using this dynamic allocation operator inside the constructor, then it is known as dynamic constructor. By using this, we can dynamically initialize the objects. So what is the meaning of this one? Generally, what is the constructor? That is your class A. Within this one, we have two data members like int A comma int B. And I just want to define a constructor, then the name of the class and the name of the constructor should be same, and it should not have any return type, not even void. And it may take parameters. So I will take like int x comma int y. This is called parameterized constructor. Within this constructor, I will try to initialize a with x and b with y. So once this constructor is done, then within the main section, that is int main section, so I will try to create this a for this a whenever I create obj, and I will send those arguments implicitly or explicitly. Like obj 1, I will take 2 comma 3. Then object 1 is created, and at the time of object creation itself, I want to initialize A with 2 and B with 3. That is done. Then that is called a constructor. That is called a constructor, and that is a parameterized constructor. And I can create another parameterized constructor like obj equal to A of 2, 5, comma 6, like this also. This is called explicit. If I want to initialize the data members implicitly, then I can write this object 1. And I can send those parameters like this. And I can create this object 2, and I can send these parameters like this. So this is called explicitly, I'm initializing those data members using constructor. Implicitly, I'm initializing those data members using constructor. So this is one thing. But what is mean by this dynamic constructor? If I am having this one, this is called parameterized constructor. If I am having this type of constructor, that is called the default constructor. And if I am having another constructor, which is taking this object, same class object as parameter, that may be by value or that may be by reference, then that is called copy constructor. And if I am defining all these constructors inside a single class, then that is called constructor. What you call?
Overloading.
Constructor overloading are multiple constructors inside a single class. I can define any number of constructors inside a class, but I can define only one destructor. Clear? Only one destructor inside a class. I can define any constructors because constructor can take parameters. Parameters is kuntaru kabatti ni no parameters toti lepothe two parameters toti lepothe another object, same class object as parameter, ఇలా డిఫరెంట్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్స్ ని నేను ఇన్సైడ్ చేయొచ్చు కాబట్టి కన్స్ట్రక్టర్ ఓవర్లోడింగ్ పాజిబుల్ బట్ డిస్ట్రక్టర్స్ అనేవి దేర్ ఇస్ సర్ యా
దెన్ వాట్ విల్ బి ఎగ్జిక్యూటెడ్ సర్ సో మెనీ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్స్ మీన్స్
యా దట్ విల్ బి డిపెండ్ ఇంప్లిసిట్ ఆర్ ఎక్స్ప్లిసిట్ విచ్ ఇస్ బెటర్ టు యూస్ యా యా ఎనీథింగ్ ఇస్ యూస్ బట్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద కేసెస్ వి విల్ యూస్ దిస్ ఇంప్లిసిట్ ఓన్లీ బికాజ్ ఇట్ వోంట్ టేక్ ఎనీథింగ్ అండ్ హౌ కెన్ యూ డిఫరెన్షియేట్ ఇస్ లైక్ ఏ ఓబిజే whenever I create this a obj then I can say directly this default constructor is executed because it is not taking any parameters and whenever I am using this one then this constructor is executed then because it is taking two parameters so it will check for the constructor with the two parameters and a obj 3 of obj 2 annanappudu then which type of constructor will be called
object 3
copy constructor
copy constructor
yeah so that can be decided at the compile time that is called constructor overloading and all these comes under compile time polymorphism endukante nenu compile time lone decide cheyagalutanu a obj anagane I can call this default constructor a obj 1 of 2 comma 3 anagane I can call this constructor and a obj 3 of obj 2 anagane I can call this can be decided at the compile time itself that is called compile time polymorphism that compile time polymorphism is achieved by using a special concept called function overloading and constructor overloading and operator overloading And there is one more concept called runtime polymorphism. In case of that runtime polymorphism, I cannot decide this calling the function at the time of compile time. I have to decide at the runtime. We will see that in the fifth chapter. And this is your destructor, and destructor does not take any parameters. And because you know multiple destructors ni create chale, so that's why destructor overloading is not possible because this destructor cannot take any parameters. And always it is having the same name as that of the class, and it should be preceded with this tilde operator. Hope. Clear, right?
Yes, sir.
Right. Next, I just want to create one more type of constructor like int a comma b and a int x comma int y and I want to allocate the memory dynamically a equal to new int and b equal to new int and after this one x is initialized to a next a will be initialized to x and b will be initialized to y so then these type of constructors are called dynamic constructor if this does dynamic constructor is nothing but if the allocation of the memory to the ikkada manaku oka di ravali that is nothing but if the allocation of the memory to the data members data members of a class okay so what is this dynamic constructor if when the allocation of the memory to the data members of a class is done dynamically using dynamic memory allocator which is nothing but new operator in a constructor that should be done inside the constructor then that constructor is called dynamic constructor hope is it clear yeah hello right
yes sir
so just we are having this extra step so whatever the memory that is allocated for this data members that should be done dynamically using the new operator so we will see some of the examples like if you are taking this example this is a class dynamic and here I am taking this this is a character array so I just want to take a character array that is nothing but you can define this character array in this manner like p of 20 anapudu I can say directly p is a character array or string which is taking 20 characters but I want to allocate the memory dynamically kabatti I will create a pointer variable so character star p and within the public section I will create a dynamic constructor that is nothing but this is the dynamic constructor in which the memory is allocating for this p dynamically by using this new operator so p equal to new char of 15 and p is initialized with some value I can also use that enter string value c in p ani kuda ivochu and I am displaying that value and I am creating this object so whenever I am creating this object then internally it will call like obj dot dynamic constructor so dynamic constructor okay so ila call avutundi obj dot internal ga epudaina constructor lo enti ante that is done implicitly like whenever you are creating the object itself that constructor will be called automatically so internal ga manaku ela avutundante obj dot dynamic constructor so it will be called and this memory for this variable that is character pointer variable will be allocated dynamically by using this new operator so whenever this memory allocation for those data members is done dynamically by using this new operator then this constructor is called what you call yeah What you call this constructor?
Dynamic constructor.
Very good. Okay. So only difference is we are allocating this memory to those data members dynamically by using new operator. And if you are taking one more example, like here we have this int star p. So this is your int star p and public dynamic constructor and allocating the memory at runtime and initializing. So I will take p equal to new int of 3. So that is nothing but I am creating an array by and I am assigning those values to 1, 2, 3. And after that one, I am displaying those values by using for I equal 0. Only thing is we are allocating those memory to those data members dynamically by using this new operator. That's it. And I am displaying those values. And after this one, I am creating. So dynamic constructor 2 star PTR equal to new dynamic constructor. So what is this one? Again, I am creating the objects also. This is called object to pointer to objects. This is called pointer to objects. So pointer to objects and approved. I am creating total 5 pointers and each pointer will each object, okay, each pointer, okay, this is I am creating pointer to object and each pointer to object will also allocate the dynamic memory allocating this memory dynamically for the each integer value. Okay, so total manaku 5 objects create ayyana gaati 5 times 1 2 3 1 2 3 display avutundi, but only thing is this 1 2 3 will be allocated dynamically. This 1 2 3 memory will be allocated dynamically. That is this one. And if you are taking one more example, like this is your dynamic constructor, I am just taking this star p, and for this p, this is a default constructor. Inside this default constructor, I am assigning, I am allocating the memory for this p variable dynamically by using p equal to new int. And after this one, I am allocating the, I am assigning the value 0 to this one. This is a default constructor, and this is dynamic constructor 3 of int x. So this is a parameterized constructor which is taking one parameter. And same, I am allocating the memory dynamically, and for this value to that particular p, I am assigning to this x, and display. I just want to display that p value. So I just want to display that p value, and I am creating this dynamic constructor obj1 equal dynamic constructor. So which constructor will be called at this place? Yeah.
Default.
So this will be called, and it will display 0 because. I am allocating this star p to 0, so that's why cy0 ane display avutundi. And parameterized constructor call cheyalante dynamic constructor obj dynamic constructor of 7. So 7 then parameterized constructor will be called, and it will allot the memory to that particular variable dynamically. Once that memory will be allocated dynamically, like 4 bytes allocate avutundi for this p variable, and some address will be allocated. And after this one, after the memory will be allocated dynamically, then only I am initializing that value to x, that is nothing but 7. So that is why it will display 7. So 0 7 will be displayed. Got it,
sir?
Yeah,
sir. If you pass parameters or arguments through main function to the class, is called
command line command line arguments. Those are, that is separate concept, command line arguments. Okay,
dynamic ante manam compile chesin tarvata execution appudu manam ichina value batti adi teeskunte dan dynamic antaru guys.
అట్లా అని కాదు, మనం మెమరీ మాత్రం అలొకేట్ చేయడం డైనమిక్ గా అలొకేట్ చేస్తాము, అండ్ ద వాల్యూస్ కెన్ బి ఇనిషియలైజ్డ్ ఎట్ ద కంపైల్ టైమ్ ఇట్సెల్ఫ్ ఆర్ ఎట్ ద రన్ టైమ్ ఆల్సో. దట్ ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్ కేస్. యూ కెన్ ఇనిషియలైజ్ దోస్ వాల్యూస్ ఎట్ ద కంపైల్ టైమ్, అంటే మీరు రన్ టైమ్ మెమరీ అలొకేట్ చేసినా ఆ టైంలోనే ఇనిషియలైజ్ చేయొచ్చు. అదర్వైజ్ ఆఫ్టర్ అలొకేటింగ్ ద మెమరీ ఆల్సో యూ కెన్ అలొకేట్, యూ కెన్ అసైన్ దోస్ వాల్యూస్ రన్ టైమ్ బై యూజింగ్ దట్ సిఇన్ సిఅవుట్ అంతే. ఓకే,
న్యూ అనే వర్డ్ యూజ్ చేస్తే ఇంకా డైనమిక్ అయినా
డైనమిక్ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్ అంతే. ఓకే, అంటే డైనమిక్ మెమరీ అలొకేషన్ విల్ బి డన్ బై యూజింగ్ దిస్ న్యూ ఆపరేటర్. అండ్ ఇఫ్ ఐఎమ్ రైటింగ్ దోస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ డైనమిక్ మెమరీ అలొకేషన్ స్టేట్మెంట్స్ ఇన్ సైడ్ దిస్ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్, దెన్ దట్ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్ ఈస్ ఆల్సో కాల్డ్ యాజ్ డైనమిక్ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్. గాట్ ఇట్?
ఓకే సార్.
రైట్, సో ఐ విల్ ట్రై టు ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ దిస్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్. యా, ఇస్ డెవ్ సి ప్లస్ ప్లస్ విజిబుల్?
Visible, sir.
Right. So this is the first one, that is main int size I, int star PTR, and enter the size of the array. So I just want to enter the size of the array. So, and after this one, I will, after entering that size of the array, then PTR equal to new int size. And after this, I think this is not the dynamic, this is just a dynamic program. And this is your dynamic constructor in which we are having this class. Inside this class, we have this dynamic constructor. And I am creating constant character star p. Okay, this you have to define like this. So generally, whenever you want to create an array of characters, then better you can use this character pointer. So then whatever, how many characters that are alerted, that will be done dynamically. And after this one, within the public section, I am creating a default constructor. This is your dynamic constructor. P equal to new char of 15. So this you can take like this 15 and you alert cheyachu, lebothe you can take one more variable like int size and chepesi you can enter the size of the characters and chepesi you can take that value at the runtime. And you can take this C++ program dynamically also. That is nothing but I will write C out enter string. So enter string. So like this, and after this one C in P. So I can take this value, but only thing is I am allocating the memory dynamically. I am allocating the memory dynamically. That to 15 characters ani nenu ikkada mention chesanu. Otherwise you can take that also, like C in C out enter size, enter number of characters, enter number of characters, number of characters ani cheppesi C in size. You can take it this manner also, like ikkada meeru ikkada kavalante meeru inkoka variable ni define cheyachu, that is your int size. After defining this one, you can take this size. So once this value is taken, and I will display by using this void display. This is a member function, and I will display. And then because of this, within the dynamic constructor, I am allocating this memory at runtime by using this new operator. Because of that, that one, I can say this dynamic constructor. This one, this is called dynamic constructor. So I am creating this object, and I am displaying this value. So I will try to compile this program. Yeah, I think C in dynamic constructor. 1 minute.
Yes, I just want to
convert that into the this character star. So explicitly I will convert. So for this one I am using this typecasting. After this one I will try to compilation done successfully. Now I will try to run this program. So enter number of characters, I will enter 5. So enter string, it is not taking. Okay, so enter string. So otherwise I will use this only. So I will directly, you just try taking dynamic values. So I will try to use this GPT master time. So like this, after this I am taking these values. I am not taking this I will try to take the characters only at the compile time. So I will try to run. So I will take 5. So GPT master time. So even I am taking 5 characters also, it is taking the entire thing, because it is, I think it is not allocating the memory dynamically. So 5 characters annapudu it has to take only 5 characters, but it is taking as it is taking entire thing, it is displaying as it is P. Even I am allocating the memory for only 5 characters, it is taking the entire value. So that is nothing but because I am allocating the even it is allocating the memory dynamically, it is taking the total characters. But anything you just try to take this as, I will try to mention it as 10. And 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 characters are there. So I will try to save this program, and after saving I will try to compile. Once this compilation is done, I will try to run. So even if I am entering 3 characters also, it is taking GPT most of the time. So because it has to take only up to 10 characters, but it is taking the total characters. So because I think as it is allocating the memory to the dynamically, so ikkada maniki, so idantha avasaram ledhu anukunte p equal to 10 ani ichanu. Now I will try to compile this. I'll try to run this GPT master thing. So it is taking the total. Okay, even if I am taking this 10 characters also, as it is not allocating the memory dynamically only for the 10 characters, it is allocating the memory according to this, say this string. Okay, so how many characters that are taking by the string, those many type of characters, this it is allocating the memory. Okay, got it, right? But only the concept you have to understand is, if you are writing these kind of new kind of statements which are used to allocate the memory for these variables dynamically inside this constructor, then that is called dynamic constructor. We will see one more example. Like this is another example. Here we have this int star p. So this is your IO stream, and after this one I am creating another dynamic constructor. Within this one I am creating the integer pointer, and within the public section I am creating this dynamic constructor, and I am allocating the memory at runtime and initializing. So I am allocating the memory dynamically for this variable integer by using this new int of 3, and I can initialize the data at the time of runtime itself. I can, after allocating the memory dynamically by using this new operator, I am initializing the data to some values like 10, 20, 30. Okay. After allocating those values, I am just displaying those values by using this for loop. You can write this entire thing in another display method also. You can write like cout endl. I think I can write this in the another method like void display. So inside this void display, I will try to write this statement like for loop. Next, after this entire thing is done, then I will try to write this. So ikkada meer idi kuda avasaram ledhu. I will just within the for loop, I will try to display those statements, and I'm creating this dynamic constructor pointer by using this way, five pointers I will create. And after this one, I will try to display like I equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. And after this one, I will try to display like PTR. If I am creating anything, then I have to use this display method. So because as I am creating this dynamic constructor, I am calling by using this display method. So dynamic constructor star PTR, I am creating total 5 pointer to objects, and after this one, I am calling this display method to display those values. So I will try to save this program. I will try to compile. Yeah, this is just a warning. I will try to run this program. So I am getting these values, right? Yeah, all of you. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I am allocating this memory dynamically by using this dynamic constructor. So this is nothing but just only within the dynamic constructor, I am allocating the memory dynamically by using this new operator. If you are taking one more example, like this is also another dynamic constructor in which I am allocating the memory for this integer variable, same integer variable only. I am allocating the memory for this integer variable dynamically by using this p equal to new int, and I am, as it is a default constructor, I am initializing that value to 0, and I am creating another parameterized constructor, and I am allocating the memory dynamically, and I am assigning that value to x. And after this one, I am just displaying that value. Just I am creating two types of constructors. One is your just it is a default constructor, and this is a parameterized constructor. Only thing is within the constructor, I am allocating the memory dynamically. So I will try to compile this, and what will be the output? I will try to run just 0.7, because in the first constructor, default constructor, which is allocating the memory for this variable dynamically, and it will assign the value to 0. And in the second parameterized constructor, it will also allocate the memory dynamically, but it will be assigned with this parameter value. So I am sending that parameter as 7. So the first one will be 0 and the second one is 7. Got it right? All of you, what is dynamic constructor? Okay.
Yes.
Okay, then thank you all.